entourage and the team as they strut live into our studios. Well, what you're seeing now is the backside of our recording, well, our station, I beg your pardon, recording studio, our station, Medikal, all clad in black with his red tie in there. And yes, he's going to join us live in the studio as well for a convo. And in 3, 2, 1, ladies and gentlemen, welcome the man who heals.
Yeah.
Medikal. Hey, welcome.
Yo. Charlie, bro, I'm in action. Charlie, I didn't want you.
You're welcome.
But shout out to my man, Kweku. Kweku's live in the building as well.
Yo, your place is beautiful.
Thank you.
Stand up.
This be the real Kweku the traveler, no. Nana, Utu Kwasi Bibi.
I swear, he's everywhere, literally.
Listen, in 1 minute, Kweku is in London. Kweku's in Amsterdam. Quick shout out to GH Kweku though, but hey, it's all good though. Medikal, welcome live in the studio, bro.
Big man, like Breakfast Club or some type of.
You say crying, crying, being a lunch club, you know what I mean?
Okay, nice.
I said breakfast, I'm out for ABD too much, you know. So, welcome to the lunch club, the Culture Daily Lunch Club. Nice. Charlie, it's been a minute, man.
It's been years, no?
Yeah.
It's been years.
Listen, I'm only social media page.
I see you do your thing as usual.
Look, make her tell you. There's this one video I like. I actually even saved it off your TikTok. It was, I think it's the best TikTok video I've seen.
I don't know why they laugh, because as you say TikTok, I know it could be one of those videos.
Wait, no, so this one will be deep. I like them. And I like whoever film them or the idea be wild. So then you they walk, you get up with then quench the light or with boys on them phone cameras.
Yeah.
With some bust some flow.
Yeah. Mr. Drew, a verse I did on Mr. Drew's song. We did like a video. It was dope. Dope stuff.
They say when your house fine, go fish it video for everywhere.
We will location.
We want a house on wave or fans on corner.
Corner.
Angle, one angle.
Yo, bro, Charlie, it's all good. Charlie Medikal, wow. Like you've been one of those people that you don't say much, but when you say it makes a lot of noise. You don't go places, but when you go, it makes a lot of noise. And one of the places you went to that made a lot of noise was our 3 Music Awards. I remember when you performed.
Yeah.
I think it was an opening like twice, right?
Yeah, twice.
Yeah. Well, let's put those visuals on the screen in a minute. Let's just do a quick throwback and watch Medikal as he jammed at R3 Music Awards. Soldier.
Hold on. Forget everybody.
Shout out to 3 Music Award now.
Comedy Mami.
Swag.
AMG Prisoners.
Swag.
The Step.
Swag.
My heart. Boy.
Forget everybody, yeah, come. Omada.
We go job life, we go make happy, we go the high.
Hey. We go job life, we go make
high.
So
we go carry. Put up on the answer again, and in the air, all the band on them. Give it up for life again, make we take them to the dance hall again. Time and time again, if you fall, we go rise and fly again. Money go come again. I agree, make people champagne. Forget about the worries. Y'all come dance again. wind up body again. And then we feel we don't have some.
We're gonna say, we're gonna
get, can I keep?
Big up 3 Music Awards. El Chiamano. Yeah, yeah. AMG, baby. Bo, 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 bo. Yeah. Flex. Swap. I'm a town in Magbeshi. You just sleep on the boy Teshi.
Yeah.
Them try shoot me. Now someone come in with Deshi. Why mono no? Me am a doc no, me am a hono. Hey, obini mi jimia, me flow bia. Yo, me am a bono, bear my ejine macho. Pow, no be today, no be today. I dey look for money like it be hide and seek with a play. Sweet like chicken fillet. Promote and then funny sick and no move go pay. Too soon I confirm me baba ji pay. Yeah, don't you traffic, we know the delay. We know the carry last. Yeah, barrier. This is a Marissa PK. Whoa. Now say emoji sing kwan, I know go talk plenty. If you hear say, me the my niggas the fight, maybe we the play MK. When I stay everywhere like Ibi Winter, Joe Hustler for Trump Kenke. Bomi D, mommy, ah!
La Hustle, yes, I la woo, yes, I la woo. Want our Shika, Jenabu, Jenabu,
too much.
Then be weak or like 7 days. Fuck it, everybody wanna act two-faced. No petrol, you can be faster than car. When you swag, 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 when you fella. Last boy, wait, talk bad about me. I try call and they say the number you have. Dark, I'll never be rich. Medical day, but I'm still 666. You don't watch me anytime, boy, tick, tick, tick. Some major will get like anybody, tick, tick, tick. You're gonna fall here, car, qua, semla, hustle, and yes, I better come. Then promise you, which I mind, that from you get chairman, or what could I mind? But you will block, I will go see some mind. Snapchat, a D-Wa, huh? Champagne I want to when you bet if you Gucci wato chama ya poso tia wanna buy see bro kwa kwe time uko kona kope sika na mwede kasa kasa mweni bete nena me bensi bo ya jisiko yes your time as slow
la osulo yes I la wu yes I la wu wanta wa shika jenabu jenabu
hustle
same question that is now yanko
mempe bad energy, men pet. I told them so I'm in pet. He's an OG and I crept. I bought 100G for a concert. Come on, that P, no more concept. Oh, get the foot in the corset. I pick out the B and you're the offset. Hustle now, fat men, that. Me go fat, bring me, pillow, name, pop. Hey, babe, we are see the SSU. Oh, they make up, me, you're the queen. I see Giza, oh, the ass out, oh, bloom. But you're the app, man, something right there, noom. Major, oh, get on me, may pay. Yeah, cool, Mary. Yeah, you wanna walk with people on cussing. Yeah, move your direction, met me round, I know this way. Any means, anyhow, which ways? Quine be a suit for the rich way. La Osulo, yes, I la woo, bow. Jimino, yes, I la woo, bow, bow. La Osulo, yes, I la woo. 3. And then what they car, Fabrami, and then what they ba, Ochadia, and then what they ma, Chabentua, and then what they sa, Ukraini, Behoya Maya, Tia Maya, Becoya Maya, Mia Belinda, Chna Monica, Chain Wazinga. Usha physics, I'm Usha lyrics, psycho. Usha me twist, I'm beside me drinks, man. The Kia don't cop, the body pains, no, be me and us. Oh, me, I'm no, I cannot comport. Oh, me, I'm no, I don't think I'm bored.
I'm
You know what, like, anytime I listen to a medical song, what even drives my interest is I'm just itching to hear what he's going to say. You know, like Chale with street terms in the world, bro, it's on another level.
Lingo.
Anytime I hear lyrics like this, I always say shout to, you know, back in the day, boys like Hillmatic. It's like, what's the guy where you do the three-headed beast?
Brack Elvin,
yeah. You know.
Skillions.
Like, yeah, you know, Chale, you guys have some terms, man. I see, NMA, yeah, Beyonce. Chale, how many times you watched this? Have you watched this? This video.
So many times. It's so dope. It's different.
Yeah, it's crazy.
It differs from a lot of, you know, creativity out there. This be different. This be top notch. And for Ghana, you get me.
So how did you feel like when you guys were in the production? Was there a lot of work? You know, I wasn't there though, but watching the final piece there, Chale.
Yo, it was so, like, there was so much work. It got to a point almost dash way, you know. And then Nico said, told me that, yo, bro, I know you want to leave. You are tired. I know you're exhausted, but I know what I want to get. So you just give me your time. Let's do this.
What time was this?
I think 2 years ago or something.
No, I mean, like, it was done, right?
Yeah, it was done. It was like, we left the set like 5 a.m. I got there like 12. I was there for like 5 hours, bro.
Chale.
Yeah. Solid. But after I saw, like, when the video came, I was like, okay, so... This one, if like I don't say if you saw a good day, if you be 1 week, say like I would be there just go.
Right now, you believe.
I believe.
Call you again, I will pull up.
Get you 1 week.
1 month, so, I did there. But the arrangement of the song shift a bit. Did that?
I think on what song? The last song?
Yeah, the last song.
The Akobam. That's Joey B's song. He featured me and Kofi Mole on it. Okay. But Mole wasn't present that day.
Okay.
I don't know. Maybe he wasn't around or I don't know. But yeah,
wow! Because I mean, look, if I watch this thing, Chale, it'd be a lot of work that went into it, you know. And one of the things I wanted to ask is, aside from three music, based on your personal experiences, do productions that engage you for performances and stuff, do they meet up to your expectation in terms of like the value of time that they're asking of you to what you go and see at the end of the day and when it comes out? Are you satisfied or you feel that there's more? Because this thing, yeah, I'm watching, not even giving self-praises, but this thing was crazy. Remake a song, you know, remake the video.
A live video, more or less.
I'm wondering, like, do productions you get yourself involved in meet up to what you wish it could be, you know?
It depends. Sometimes, they always get what you want, but people like 3Music, Foresight Awards, VGMA, you know, they always, you know, put in more work and then show something nice, showcase something nice. At the end of the exhibition, you go feed talk, say, oh, this is dope. Maybe there'll be some 1 or 2 way, maybe they go feed ad, but each and every day, they all keep, you know, they keep, you know, bringing in their best work, making efforts to create something very nice. So
I mean, shouts to Ignis doing Foresight TV. I mean, no two ways. He's putting some work, you know, when it comes to
place setter,
creating a certain magic around some brands, though. Anyway, I don't know. We should talk about. Let's still stick on the performances, though. You recall your 2019 performance? On this one, the one where I think that was the one you
brought
in
the red one. Yeah, I brought what?
You brought out the bikes.
Yeah. It was dope. It was something different. You know me, I be street boy, so sometimes I like to, you know, I like to showcase certain things that goes on the street. It's nice. Sometimes you be driving, you see some bikers on the street, some will be popping a wheelie. Unfortunately, they couldn't do stunts on the stage due to, you know, one or two reasons, but I just wanted that picture. I wanted to see that image of me being on stage with bikers around me. Yeah, so it was dope. Yeah,
it's dope. Was just dope. Medikal, how is it like for you when you jump on stage and like your fans, the reaction from? I realize that you write your songs thinking of the performance in mind. If I can say that, reaction like talk a rap small, you could talk something. I don't know if you have that in mind. So what if you
like
write your
engagement?
Song,
in my rap, you're not just rapping to finish the beat, but you deliver some bars, some engagement, or like you said, some terms to connect, and then so when you're performing, that kind of brings it out more.
Okay, I know they write my songs, like Because of how I won't see how the performance go.
No, not performance, like the crowd.
The crowd. Yeah. Okay, you know why it's like that? Because you see, with me, I use most of the street terms. Like when I normal lingo or lingua or whatever it is that anybody go understand, you get me? So whenever I'm performing, people can't wait to hear saying things like that, you get me?
Mm-hmm.
So fortunately for me, I did put some terms in there, and then when I'm on stage, they keep screaming. They can't wait to hear that part.
Which songs would you say, you know, like if you drop out, Charlie, the crowd, my reaction, and then how did it flow with you, and the, which of your jams really works out
for
you?
Oh, my Azonto jams. Like I do it by Accra, Omada, you know? Like those songs, they really like it. Because, you know, those songs be songs where you go, if you dance to arm, if you jam to arm, make noise. I'm not saying they don't like the hip-hop songs, too. Yeah. They do. Mm-hmm. I have a lot of hip-hop songs that, like La Hustle, Confirm, Pegaka, they still vibe to it. But when it's danceable, you know, they are dancing and they are singing at the same time.
It's so more of a party.
Like, yeah, like a party, yeah.
Charlie, finish.
Do you take your fans into consideration when you are making your music? That's because of some of the terms. I mean, you've been on the street long enough to know what resonates with them. So are your fans a huge part of your music creation process?
Yeah. My fans, they'll be the reason why I do the music. I do the music because of them. I mean, I think about them when I'm doing music, you know, sometimes. And you see, there are some fans where they really like maybe hip-hop. Like that, somebody did some sideway. He like, you know, Azonto. He won't dance. He won't jump. He's there for the fun. Maybe when it comes to like inspirational songs, that's different. Mm-hmm. There's another person. Yeah, I know. So I'm pair danceable songs, but I'm pair, you know, hip hop songs like conscious music, like rap bars, like what my big man for a year they do most of the time. You know, he drops bars like Ghost Deep, but like he's dope.
Nana.
You hear me? So.
Yeah,
so I mean, really? Yeah, I think of that too. But you know if you feed only one part, or I know if you partition them and give a whole portion to, you know, the dancers and other whole to, you know, after partition them, well, everybody forget in share. When it comes to inspirational music, you can listen to Father. When it comes to my rap, you can listen to La Hustle or God Bless You or something. When it comes to Azonto, you can listen to Omada. You get me? So it'll be out on it, yeah.
If you had your own way, assuming audience know they will, I be you in studio. What you gonna do?
That's deep.
I know, right? Will they change the? I say, will they change the music?
Yeah. Because I listened to you from the beginning, though.
For real?
Yeah. Oh, my sir.
That's dope.
I checked the whole dynamic. So and the question that I said, that they asked.
That's very deep.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's very deep. But yeah, if let's say I would be making music for myself. I think I'll do a lot of hip hop music because I like rap. I like to rap a lot. I like to pour my heart out and show how, you know, creative I am and punchlines, metaphors, and all.
The reason I ask that, your answer be perfect. The reason I ask that is because no matter the song you do, inspirational, Azonto, jams, whatever, your whole swag, your whole demeanor still be hip hop.
Mm-hmm.
I noticed that no matter what you jump to on the stage, Omwada or whatever, blah, 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 your whole demeanor still be hip-hop. Even though they jump to Omwada, you don't change being a hip-hop person at heart.
That's true.
I mean, just pay attention. Maybe you've not noticed it, but when you watch
how,
videos...
Based on that question, how do you feel in this Afrobeat space where singing has become like a, you know... As Bibia dances, every, you know, every song coming out right now, they go sing and they go dance to them and create something right now. No, when they do Kevin Boy right now, dope nation to drop, clap, you know, everything will be dance. How do you feel as somebody who's a strong hip hop lover in this space right now?
You see, somebody like me, Medikal, I'll be dominant in all the genres, you get me? I know how to put myself in this space, put myself in that space. So I know be the type of artist where maybe I do only one genre. Like, let's say I'm doing just Afrobeat. So right now, I can't rap or I can't drop, you know, rap tracks. It's going to feel or look weird to certain listeners. You get me? I'm everywhere. When you play Azonto, you go hear my song. When you play hip hop, you go hear my song. When you play some singing, you go hear my song. When you play Afrobeat, you go hear my song. So I just feel like, the era we're within, if you're an artist, you should be, you know, you shouldn't limit your talent. You get me? You should be able to, you know, spread your
wings. So talking about that, Medikal, I'm now looking at you again and saying that, wait, this guy in collaboration list they keep him very lean.
For real?
Unless
are you saying I do less collaborations?
I don't know, but okay, so has Medikal done any collaborations outside GH? I should say that.
Mm. Yeah. I did Father with Davido.
Okay, yeah. Father with Davido.
And then I have a couple of songs with... Yeah, I think I have. I do. But maybe it's not quite often. That's why you're saying that. But I have a couple of songs with people outside Ghana. So artists outside Ghana.
Who you jam with the most? Who you feature the most?
Who I do songs with?
Yeah, the most.
Shatta.
Because we family.
Shatta, I have too many songs with him.
But aside him, in there be family, so I no go count them.
Aside Shatta, I think Joey B. I have a lot of songs with Joey too.
Unreleased.
Plenty. We have like, I think Joey and I, we have like 10, like more than 10, I think. Wow. If I'm correct. Yeah, I have a lot of songs with Joey.
And that disease with artists, they will keep it.
But they play out for studio. They jam for studio.
You know, as you catch outside when you park, I think you're playing a song in the car. I wanted to come and ask you, say, Chai, that song where I didn't know we release it, and I said, we release it.
I mean, you know, I'm working on, I'm about to release an album, planning and plotting. So I keep, you know, I know it happens to you a lot, right? When you record a song and you listen to them. You go hear some part and be like, nah, let me go correct.
Mr. Talk up like this, like, will be better.
Thank you very much. So that's what I'm going through right now. The album is done. I'm just going through, you know.
But that be creative disease, so that they worry you. Because me like this, the amount of people who vex me, say, music game machine talk for studio way, you know, day streaming. Mm-hmm. Yeah. It'd be more. How do you finally decide that it good? You make the exporter make we upload. When do you close your chapter? Because if you listen up more, those things go, they come.
Yeah, it's a struggle, you know. It's crazy. Mm. But sometimes I just go like, you know what, let me just release a song so that they listen to it. Because if you keep doing that over and over again, you might end up even losing it. Usually, if you listen to some song at it right now, the song will be you again. Yeah. Then you feel like, nah, this song...
Emotionally says, go disconnect self from them.
You get me? Then you feel like maybe you record something new, so that new one will go make sense. Yeah. You get
take
me?
Take your attention.
Yeah.
So you just mentioned that. Before that, let's shout out to our brother Olele live in the building right now. Hey, bro, what's up? Yeah, man. Salvador.
Yes, sir. What's up?
Charlie, so like I was asking, I nearly missed out my thoughts there, but you mentioned your album in the making. You're working on that. What? Planning and Plotting.
Planning and Plotting, yeah.
That's the album title.
Yeah.
Inspired by?
Myself, Charlie. Who I go through my life, experience, a lot of things.
Is that what we're going to feel in this album?
Yeah, I think you're going to feel more of Medikal, my story, my struggle. Of course, there's going to be a bit of party here and there on the album, but I did talk more of my struggle, pain, the journey we have, you know, we have gone so far.
I'm sure we're going to definitely get that story in the album. I don't know if you have all the full details, how many songs you're hoping to, you know, drop on that album and when you probably plan on releasing the album as well.
Yeah, so I'm looking at 15 songs on the album.
Mm.
And then... I'm looking at summer. I was supposed to drop the last year, but then I feel like I've put in more works more before it comes out. Cause this be album way. This go be my greatest, you know, body of work. I think.
Wow,
summer dear. Then you mean say make ready be that?
Oh, the album make ready. I just go through that. What I explained to you.
Right. So you're checking again.
Yeah, I'm just
some paper. I'm small.
Mm-hmm. And I want to get some videos ready. You know. Get some one or two things in line before the album.
Any Keith? Question.
Well, then
same question with the cars.
Are you guys in each other's heads?
any key features, collaborations, anything, any surprises on there?
Yeah, there are dope features on there, dope collaborations.
Anybody you want to tell us?
Oh, Joey B day top, I know, but Joey B day top, Saturday top. Pick one for day.
Joey there for day top.
For day top.
Saturday
for day top.
You must be members of the council. They there for day.
You understand? You know one thing about Joey? Joey be somebody we sometimes, you know, he likes working and all of that, but sometimes it'd be very hard to get them. Like, as I talk to you right now, if I do a verse for some song of mine that I'm yet to release, you know, I'll be dropping something called a Planning and Plotting Interlude. What I'm doing is I'm gearing my fans towards the album. You get me? So some singles will come out before the album. And he's supposed to do a verse. It's been like a month. Every day if you call him, ooh, Charlie, I go into studio, no. So, but they understand, of course, this job, you know, be easy.
Yeah.
Somebody go there somewhere and feel like, yo, I need a verse from you. You're not doing the verse for me. And then, but the person go forget, say, maybe you do verses for the person before, or you do a verse for the person before, and the person go online, go talk some things like that. Sometimes there's certain things where they go through, Charlie.
Right.
So, you know, easy.
Right. I know, right? You had it will be easy. And you have to make sure you vibe with the beat and then the
maybe so you know they in the mood. Yeah.
Dealing with your own problems.
Me sometimes when I don't get money, I don't like record.
Somebody but if you don't get money, when they get in the search for medical.
Me I don't get anything.
And then if you don't get money, then what?
Lie. She doesn't get money. The way she make words,
what should
get money.
We say? Medikal is saying he doesn't have money. What should we say?
You know, sometimes you're not in the mood to just record because maybe they go through certain things. Maybe not financially, self, but maybe
other emotional breakdowns. Yeah. I can imagine. It's true. Now, are there any aside from the video one and a few others you've done, as a rapper, like, have you connect plus any of the Khaled Gav Jones and, you know, all the other artists outside Africa, outside MCs Ghana, outside. Sorry.
Yeah, I have a couple. I don't want to mention, but the album will come out. You go hear something dope. Some, like, American artists and UK rappers as well. And I think I have something with an East African artist. I can't really remember the name. I don't want to say something wrong.
Yeah,
okay. But he's also dope. Check out on the album itself. It's dope.
Planning and plotting. Wow. Yeah.
He mentioned Shatta will be on that album, right?
Yeah, but I have a song with him.
With Shatta on the album. I would love for you to share with us how that beautiful friendship we see on social started. Mm. How did you, you know, get close to Shatta? How did you guys create that bond that you have?
You know, one thing a lot of people don't know is I've known Shatta for so many years. We've been friends for like 6-7 years ago. The first time I did a song with him was, I think, 6 years ago. Mm-hmm. You get me? And then we've been communicating a lot. We stayed in touch. But it'd be just recently, maybe we've been, you know, doing a lot of things more. People see us together more because we are doing some businesses together, like Shaxi. We do a lot of shows together. We get a lot of deals together. And I feel like it's because of the... because I'm in the same business. He's an artist. I'm an artist too. Mm. You get me? So, and when we come together, we create this gel and then it becomes a big bang and then people love it. So why not? I feel like with unity, we go do a lot of things, you know.
I see you have the Shaxi wristband. Two, actually.
Yeah, I have three, actually.
Three. Okay, the black is also Shaxi.
Yeah.
Now, mentioning that you are doing business with Shatta, is Shaxi part of those businesses? And if you would also let us in on any other businesses. I mean, if you can't and you won't, that's fine. But if you can let us in, and in what capacity are you aboard Shaxi?
Shaxi, I know maybe you've seen some stuff about Shaxi online. So it's an app, right? For the drivers and people who want to order rides. I don't want to make... Okay, let's say like Uber or Bolt or something. Mm-hmm. But this one is, you know, it's more better. Like, it's much better, sorry. People, the commission be cheap. You know, they like Uber and Bolt where they go charge you expensive. You don't even get ride stuff. And then they tear you some way, you know. And I'm a board chairman on the... Like in a company.
Nice. Okay.
Chemo.
El Chemano. They don't call him El Chemano for nothing.
Charlie, speaking of business.
But no, he didn't finish. She was going to ask other businesses.
We are into real estate too. Like, we are into building, selling, renting, working with companies and so on. You know, things.
Say, Kasa.
And of course, the music to the shows, you know, endorsement deals, you know, coming together with brands to create something.
Is this a joint business or independent? But is it that you have interest in, you know, like, is it registered businesses together, as in the two of you, or independent?
No, it's actually
the same kind of business.
It's actually independent, but you see, it's like him supporting mine, and I'm also supporting his. I'm into real estate a lot. He doesn't have time like that, so he likes the upside, and me too, I support him for the upside. You get me? But me, I'm mostly, if you watch my snap, you go see, I did some side for somewhere. Sometimes I go there, you know, to make sure they're doing the right thing, you know.
But I see Waddle. I spoke to Waddle on that as well.
Yeah, Waddle is into that too,
as well. And then this morning, we're also speaking about Becca. We see some videos online. She too wears some helmet this on site.
Yeah.
So we make like the creative space.
We are all missing.
Yes. No matter how you take from my mouth, because these are my people. I don't see my people. I follow my TV and see them. But this is the one on the TV. Four man. If you say... Is it like trying to reinvest the music money? Or is it that the music money is not consistent, so you need to have something that's big money to make sure that the background be solid? Because everybody I know now, D Black is doing it, Waddle, you, Shatta, Becca, the girls, all the entire stuff. So what be that migration? It didn't used to be like that.
I know. Of course, right now, if you check, you know, say, there's no artist there where go feel rain forever. I know if he... reign for 50 years. You get me? Maybe when I turn 50, maybe if I go even still record song, you know, go be with the mindset of, you know, getting shows to go jam, to go there. Maybe I will figure endorsement deals, or maybe if I decide once in a while, if you do a show do like a legend like Daddy Lumba and all of that. But I feel like it makes sense to create a generational wealth with who you are. You get me? I don't want to, you know. I know everybody go die eventually. I don't want to leave, then maybe it'd be just my legacy as Medikal being a rapper. I want my offsprings to, you know, come and see some building or some school or some, you get me, something where then go feel also eat off. And them to them are, you know, offsprings go eat off. But right now, hopefully, the way the next of kings they do, no, Charlie, maybe man go change his mind because then they bought too much, Charlie.
Speaking of investment. I mean, before we get into the family side, you talk something nice. I like, I want to know about the kiddie and all that, but we'll get there. The Soul Tomb concert. Why stop? That'll be your personal brand. That'll be your cash cow. Me, if you say, what I saw at the beginning, I thought we'll expand on them and all that, especially with all this year of return and all these that, people they come, you'll be big brand.
Yeah.
What leads to the hiatus on that?
Okay, I don't know if you heard, but a lot of people were injured at that concert.
Yeah.
Some fans climbed they climbed the scaffold and the speakers came down. About 20 people were injured. I personally had to drive some of them to the hospital. Yeah. You know, and after that happened, like, I just felt like it was too gory to me that I didn't have the, you know, courage to do that again. But I spoke to my team and then they want us to do it this year. So
solid.
Moving forward, solid. This year we'll have that, and then we'll have the planning and plotting experience as well. That one is going to be at maybe, you know, Dome or somewhere like
so it'll be two experiences, two different audiences kind of.
Yes.
Solid.
Yes.
Now,
solid.
Medikal, I'd like to ask about your fans, right, who got injured at the concert. You know, some months ago, we heard stories of people saying you've not followed up with them, you've not actually paid for the bills, you know, all of those things, right? Yeah. Would you want to get into that as well? Have you been able to keep up with some of them, actually followed up and maybe checked up how they're doing, even as of now? Because with you, we can even tell how much of an impact that made on you for you to put a stop to it.
Yeah, so I took care of most of them. I mean, all of them, actually. And I was left with this one guy. I kept paying the bills. They kept sending me videos of how he was doing, how he was faring. I kept sending money. And then I was there one day. I was in America, and I saw a video online of someone talking about the fact that I've abandoned a fan and I haven't paid any medical bill. And after, they took me to court. I was called to come to court. And I'd already spent like almost 60,000 cedis for that side. So I was confused. You get me? But I mean, I even rubbished all those things they did, and I still made my team reach out to them to support them with something.
Oh, great.
Yeah.
It's good to know you're still supporting at least to an extent. So that's good.
So a lot of rappers or artists that have given birth like to show their daddyship, if I can say that.
Yeah.
Yeah, daddy, they show their daddiness.
Yeah.
You know, yeah, we already do.
They try to be cute, you know.
Yeah, you know, you raise your kiddie, hold them and all that. I hardly see you, and I want to even, let me even ask, how is it being a daddy?
It feels
What kind of father are you?
I mean, I'm a very, I'm a daddy of the year. I for do that t-shirt to myself and a mag.
And for take climb
stage.
I agree with that.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, I love my daughter actually, Island. I love her so much. You know, that's my first child. So anytime I see her, I get so happy. Sometimes I personally drop her off at school and then pick her up sometimes. We spend a lot of time together. We take pictures a lot. I don't know why you're saying you don't really see that.
I haven't, but probably I've missed out on that, but on that part of it. But so how is it for you, like, you know, watching your offspring? This is not your business, so it's your offspring.
Yeah,
you
it's dope. Sometimes if you watch him, I'll be like, hey, Charlie, so me too, I get my kid with this.
You're human being.
It feels weird sometimes, like, this be my, you know, my sperm, you know.
How is she like? What kind of girl is she? What are some of the things? Do you see traits of yourself? No.
That's so
what cool. What's the guy want to talk to me? Say, you know, this make I talk boy talk. Only the boys for you understand.
Change.
You spill the rest. Like, you
Lenny left the chat.
Charlie, you're the only human being. Yeah. You own cars, property, and now you own human being.
She didn't show any signs of you in, I don't even mean music. Like, you see mannerisms, things about you.
Stubborn.
Yeah, she did show some one or two. She did mimic me in some way. Sometimes in act, the way she did act, and if you see her and be like, the mom, if you go like, oh, yeah, this is all papa, you know. she's dope.
But Charlie, but you if you defeat Tease Boy, so let's say you and Fela do some video, this video says, now you know you guys did some swimming pool inside. They chop some love. Yeah, it was some swimming pool. I think you carried Fela. Family moments. I was like, this guy likes to really brag and show off his family, you know.
I mean, I think everybody they do. Everyone does that, but my own come light because maybe I be celebrity. Some people till they do away, they know they put up.
Oh, so why they point me?
Some people they do away. Why they do away?
They do pass. But you know they put them.
Why?
I go put them today because of you.
No problem.
I go put one because of you.
I'm promising because of Medikal.
I go repost it. I go tell you.
No problem.
Charlie, what is it like? Me, I'm married. How many years I'm married now? 2 years. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You married before I marry Seth. How is it like? Because you be celebrity, pressure day everywhere. Wife, you be celebrity, pressure day everywhere. How you did one?
I just feel like, bring your personal life and the showbiz life together. You get me? Once you do that, it brings some, a lot of confusion, ego, a lot of things. Because you see, wifey to be celebrity, you get me? She be star, she be public figure. But when we day house, it's not like that.
So when you day house, you know, be Medikal and Fela McCaffrey.
No.
It be who and who?
It be Samuel and...
Precious.
Hey, Charlie. So Samuel and Precious, they have them cool. They be mommy and daddy, husband and wife. Yeah, they do their matter.
Yeah, but when we come out swacking...
Then you activate. And has those like moments that you said, of course, Charlie, you go try keep on real everything, but those superstar moments, you ever they cross for us? Like maybe you from stage, you go perform, the whole Accra, they make noise, convoy, entourage, everything. The open gate, you enter house. You for leave all that for the gate, too.
Yeah, you for leave for
then someone enter.
Yeah, someone.
Hey, on God.
Precious, they get more views past
Samuel. So
Precious post.
So someone they go meet star for us.
They go meet star for us. I'm telling you, yo, when Fela puts up a post, like she they clock 90 something thousand, 100,000 straight.
It's crazy.
She's got crazy numbers.
Do you have competitive moments? Like what Jay they talk. Like maybe you post something like 3 days cool, some 50K likes in 3 days cool. Then she post something that early morning. Then the thing they like some 200K.
You know they check those things.
Oh.
You sure?
Me, I hardly they read comments self. Like we know they check like the only thing me I they check be money. That one, I will. But likes and comments, and we know really they check those things. We just like they work hard. We always working. She go work. Me too. I go enter studio. They record or go somewhere. Like I did interview you like this. I'm working still. You get me? So we don't really check those things and be like I get like pass you. No, we don't do that.
Because I know say Kim K then Kanye, they do tire.
No, very soon. You wait. Fela will start charging Medikal for posts. Because you want views? Baby, you want the views? With a peck of crazy Brian.
I want to post the plotting and planning artwork. So how much? Send some mumu. Send some mumu.
We just showed a part of the engagement a couple of years. How was it for you? Because like Cyril was saying, right at a very young age. How was it for you going through that space of, asking for a woman's hand in marriage? The public, people's opinions, what people are saying, family and all that. How was that experience in the moment for you?
It was different. I just feel like as a man, you should be able to take a step. You get me? You should be able to go through whatever it is. You shouldn't look back and feel like, hey, the pros and cons or whatever is going to come out of it. I just understand, this life we they live, no matter what, we go expire. Everybody get expiring day. You get me? So as you live their life, you for enjoy them, you for live every moment. Because when you die, you don't set any record. People die plenty. Every day, people they die every day, then they born new people. So you just have to live their life.
I beg you, no go tell Shatta make him marry.
When you see him there, you tell him.
You guys talk about him before, like.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
What does he say?
He say he's looking for the right person. He's looking for the right one.
If he say Goofy Barry.
Oh, why not? I never think that Goofy Barry.
The right person.
Yeah,
person will be that spec. Maybe we go for help him.
Yeah.
If we know the spec, maybe we go send candidate.
You see, sometimes it no be the spec, it be
the character,
the subine,
the mental,
the
emotional.
It be plenty things. Somebody go visit some girl, be like, oh, this girl is so beautiful. She's intelligent. She's a lawyer. She has this and that. But the inside, you know, I say.
Maybe you know, if you're a demon.
Well, I wanted to find out from you, obviously, we've talked about the highs in your career, but let's talk a bit about the lows. I think some time ago, you deleted all your photos on Instagram. You just went missing. Nobody knew what was happening. Some were even suggesting that you and your wife, you know, were splitting up. A whole lot of interesting stories. Obviously, you don't speak to such matters, but maybe you want to throw some light on
it. I don't mind, actually.
Okay, so share with us, you know, the lows, the difficult times, you know, your career. Have you got to the point where you had to quit? You wanted to quit this music thing, focus on something else, relocate outside Ghana? Just share on the lows with us.
Well, there's never been such thoughts of me quitting music or relocating, but sometimes I just feel like I need to redecorate myself. You get me? Like, so when you get on my page and see that I've deleted all my pictures and that, it doesn't mean I'm going through some, you know, recessions or going through something very deep, or it's just me trying to come up with something different. Yeah, but I mean, every human being, if he go down, your low state of mind, if he come, if he get depressed sometimes, maybe it'll be about money or your music or sometimes life, maybe you need something else, you get me? And then the thing, they go the way they want make it go, if you go through that. But when you see my page, I'm just redecorating things.
Does it get lonely sometimes? I mean, everybody, MDK, but does it get lonely with you
MDK,
sometimes?
Lonely.
No, it actually does, you know.
Sir?
Yeah, sometimes I wish to just, you know, go to the beach, walk alone, and then, like, be able to, you know, go sit. There was this favorite spot of mine at Sotin where they had the chop beans for. I don't know if you go there again, because when you enter there, it'll be pictures and you get me?
If I show love.
That one's every normal, but you see, sometimes you they miss
The quiet, the peace of mind.
Yeah, the peace of mind, and you know, you see some maybe bar or something. You want to enter there, go take some shots. You know, you just won't feel different because it's always bougie.
The part I side with you is when do you remember when somebody called you Samo? Who calls you by your real name?
Who calls me by my real name?
I mean, everybody calls you Medikal. Everybody,
yeah, it's crazy. I don't even, yeah, it's crazy. Yeah, everybody, they call me. Even my mom, they call me Medikal now. My mom calls me Medikal now. It's crazy. So, you know, sometimes, yeah, you miss being in that. It be great life, I guess. I don't even know how to.
The reason I'm asking this is because circa 20, I don't know what year, I've forgotten, but the day you were snapped a lot of awards at the VGMAs, Papi Kojo, in an interview, said he went into a serious depressed state. There was a particular year you were supposed to have received a number of awards. You didn't get them.
Yeah.
And then I wondered how you bounced back from that. Or would you count that as part of the lows in your career? Because you worked so hard that year. And then that recognition wasn't given.
Yeah, I know. I mean, it doesn't feel nice to lose, you know. Everybody go like win. When you're nominated like 8 times, yes, and you're sure that at least you're going to get some 1 or 2, and you don't get one award at all, you go feel some type of way. But me, I did do the music because it's my passion. You get me? I'm not. I didn't. It be recently, like a few years ago, where I come to say you can make a lot of money in music. You get me? Through music, so it still be passion. That's why sometimes I drop some songs and people be like, "Why? What type of song is this? How is this song gonna win a Grammy?" I'm just doing what I love to do, and I'm entertaining my fans. You get me? I don't have this goal like, "Hey, percent me anyway, and you bro." Yes, no, I'm just doing my thing. I'm just doing me. So I feel like sometimes awards and those things, it'd be good to win awards and stuff. But when you know when, you shouldn't feel like it's the end of the world, and it shouldn't lead you to depression and you know.
Yeah. So let me come, just because you mentioned the depression and you know, depressing moments and low points. I don't know if I can chip in how that whole you know, going through the jail process, yeah, and coming some, out. I mean, that can be a defining moment. Mm. I wouldn't say a low point. It can actually be a high point. Mm. You know,
change. What did jail teach you basically? What going to jail teach you basically?
It taught me that no matter how powerful, rich, successful you are, your freedom can be taken away from you. You should value freedom more than anything. You should cherish freedom like a breathing space, air. Even if you are broke, you should just appreciate the fact that you are alive and you are not caged like an animal. You get me? So Joe taught me that, yo, I have to be very humble. I tried to be humble, but you know, when I went to jail, I went to listen to stories of people. I wasn't even sad for myself, you know, because I knew that, yo, I haven't really committed a crime like that. I no go steal, I no go rob, I no kill anybody, I no go insult anybody's self. You get me? So when I got there, I met a lot of wealthy people there, and then some matters we lead them to there. You know, it make us say, yo, we should really appreciate our freedom. You get me? You need to stay out of trouble. Yeah, that's what he taught
me. What was the conditions like, you know?
It was like jail. Like, jail, you're on a metal bed, no AC, no TV, you know?
Was it crowded?
Crowded. Crowded.
The washroom
day inside where you did. Like, this, half of this room where we did sleep, where the street tomb, no? It did somewhere like here. You get me? You did see somebody there. You get me? Like, it's crazy. It's not nice. It's not something nice to wake up to. You get me? So I just feel like everybody for stay out of trouble. And then be strong, though. Even when something happens to you and you find yourself in that position, just be strong. And then when you come out, stay out of trouble, but keep your brain intact, and then not say you are doing this thing for you and nobody else, and stay out of trouble. That's the most important thing.
Were you able to, you know, blend in with them? I mean, you just described how someone is taking a dump and then you are there. Mm. Did you have them
taking a dump?
Taking a dump. I don't want to. Please, Gen I beg.
Like, did you?
Was that she embarrassed?
Oh, what's all this? But yeah, I was asking, were you able to properly blend in with them, quote unquote, properly? Mm. And then also, did you put yourself in the position to allow them see you take a dump and all of that?
Yeah, you see, me, I've been through a lot of things already before I became medical. You get me? So, me, I sleep for Kaneshi under bridge before. Because it got to a point in my life, I was selling phones, like a Kaneshi Circle. So that type of lifestyle, no, it no be anything different. You get me? Recently, where God can bless me, where I can blow and all of that. So, you know, seeing people do that, I just blended in quickly because as I say, okay, this be where I find myself. So I know if you do anything about them, I'm going to be here for like 10 days or whatever. So make I just adjust. Accept and myself. Then I had fans there too. So it'll be like the normal prison movie you go watch and then they bully people left and right. It's not like that over there, actually. That's not what I saw. But we weren't given any VIP treatments, like they are treating us like stars. No. We were going through the same thing. They lock us up at like 6 in the evening, and then they open like 5. And then, yeah, a lot of things.
You know what I find interesting? Often rappers tend to imagine these situations in their lyrics and their verses, right? Mm. And now you are faced with reality.
Mm.
So I'm just looking at when you had that reality check.
Mm.
Like, look, I rap about this, I saw Dean, or like do all these, like there was a particular video you shot, I think you were in jail clothes, and
that was after they got out.
That was after. Yeah. But I'm just saying that like some rappers do, like they
mimic that
until they actually get into it.
Yeah.
Right? I'm not saying you've done that before, but I'm just saying that comparing the two,
the culture shock
and then of course having to see exactly what reality, goes on in the jail. Yeah. What was it like for you?
It was, you know, people paint this picture, or people, it's in the minds of people. Like, people have this perception about jail that, yo, this is how, like, people are killing people.
Yeah.
But that's not what I saw. You get me? I saw unity over there.
Mm.
Yeah, I saw unity. There's love over there. People don't, They don't just wake up stabbing people or fighting. They don't do that. They share food together. They preach. The last time I had prayed before going to jail was like 2 years ago, bro.
Wow. Mm.
But when I woke up, the first day I woke up, they were singing worship and prayers, and I joined them, and we prayed.
Mm.
Yeah, so, you know, going through that, that be why at the talk say planning and plotting go be my best body of work, like best art where I will put out there, because I spoke about, you know, a lot of things in there.
Was Shatta in the same space with you?
Yeah, his cell was opposite mine.
Okay.
You know if he's young, but when he shouts, you will be young.
What was the reception like? You know, how people, how were the inmates like, you know?
They were so excited to see us there.
Wow.
Did you guys do like a performance or something? Like both of you?
Oh, I used to rap for
entertainment
my...
Entertainment night.
Yeah, something like that. Like when you did dorm and you did rap, same thing. I did that in my cell. I used to do that every night. There was this guy down there, beneath my bed, he was a rapper. So when you wake up, they go to play beats, then we go to rap. So they had a rap with them.
Who would you not forget in that cell?
Steven Dadzi. There was this guy in the cell. I gave him a shout out on one of the songs, Obolo. That's what he's called, Steven Dadzi, aka Obolo. His story is very sad. I wish I could say the story, but I don't know if I'm even prepared mentally to, you know.
Just have an idea.
Yeah, so, Obolo. So, yeah, he's in for 30 years.
Oh.
Yeah, he's, right now, I think, 32. So he will come out at 62, you know.
And he's been in for, like, how long?
But when I got there, he had already been in for 6 months. So he did continue.
Wow.
It was very sad, you know. But yeah, all the same, I pray maybe they reveal.
Is there a situation of unfair justice or delayed justice?
You see, the world and Kasa right now, I think everything be money. Somebody day inside for like a year, we maybe in prosecutor for just come and then taking documents, go give a lawyer, make them review the case. Mm-hmm. If we kill them, go jail them. So, and there are some people there where they don't even know if they go jail them or they go release them. They don't even talk them a matter at all. And they've been there for like 5 years.
Mm. Wow.
Yeah, so...
This Obolo story, like, I want to hear just me.
Okay, so he was... apparently, this is what he said to me. He was a receptionist at some hotel, and some armed robbers came there, and they came to rob some foreigners, yeah? So when they got there, unfortunately, one of the foreigners were struggling with them, and then they shot the man, and then he died. So Obolo got arrested because apparently he was a receptionist, and the police believed that he connived with the robbers to do that operation.
Without any evidence?
That's what he said to me. I mean, that's the story. So it was sad. Hearing something like that is sad. Even if maybe he participated himself, knowing that, somebody, young man like this, to go to jail for 30 years.
That's his whole life.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
I mean, I don't know if you've thought about this, but do you think, having experienced these stories, do you think it's something you want to take on as a CSR? You know, like the way Kim Kardashian is doing for, you know, people who have been jailed wrongfully and all that. Do you think it's
prison reforms?
Like prison, because I think Christian Achu partnered with the Crime Check Foundation to do that for other prisoners.
Mm.
But because you have experienced this firsthand, do you think it's something you want to do as part of your corporate social responsibility?
Yeah, I would definitely love to do something like that. You know, people who are in situations like, you know, below story, and or maybe they can review their story and find, you know, witnesses, and if what he's saying is that does make sense and he had no hands in the operation, I don't see why he should be locked up for the rest of his life. So I'd love to do that, but maybe not right now, because right now I'm not in that, my state of mind would be there right now, but it's something that eventually I wouldn't be surprised to find myself.
How long did it take for you to come back to life after you left jail? How long did it take?
As I did daddy, I was in life. I was back. Hello. I was just experiencing something different. It was weird and, you know, I would say wonderful, but it was surreal to me, like, to be there. Because I like watching jail documentary, like the Mexican prisons and Pablo Escobar.
Yeah.
So being there, I was like, shit, he is in jail, like, for real. Like,
how the family take this?
Does your daughter know?
Nah, she doesn't know. I'll tell her when she's maybe 4 years old or 5 years old. Or maybe she'll find out.
She will find out.
Or when she's able to grab
internet, your real daughter that will call her, hey, yeah. Island, do you know?
Island, do you know? You know, daddy?
Yeah.
I know.
But
I
how, did family take it? You know, like when I say family, I mean like, you know, extended family and all.
How did you even take it? Like worrying about family?
Yeah, that was the problem. Yeah, I wasn't worried about myself. Yeah, I knew that I'm a survivor, you know. But my like my nuclear family, both nuclear and extended family, friends, you get me, even fans, I was very concerned because I knew that they were devastated. But I just, you know, kept praying that they'll, you know, be strong for me and then know that I'll come out. I'll come out successfully. I'll be good and nothing is going to happen to me and everything will be resolved.
All right, I think it's getting a bit mushy for me. Let me just a bit.
I want to cry.
One of the songs that I would never forget was Connect, 2016. That was how I got introduced to you. You rapped in EL's voice, Joey B, Sarkodie, Omar Sterling, Chris Waddle, Yapo, no Kofi Kinata. One person. You did all these verses in their tonations, in their delivery, cadence, whatsoever. Talk to me about that song. I've been always wanting to ask you because what you did was very rare at the time, you know. And if anybody hadn't really heard of you at the time, they would think you actually featured all these acts.
Yeah, yeah.
Was that your toughest project yet?
I think, you see, one thing about me is I like to be different. I like to create something new. I like to do something that, you know, no one has ever done. Maybe people have done, but maybe we don't really hear them, you get me? I like to create something different. So I just wanted to, you know, work extra hard and then reach the same mileage by doing something like that. And, you know, it caught, that's what caught your attention, right?
Yes.
You get me?
Yeah.
So I achieved that goal of doing that. And then I adored, you know, this be, they adore the people where I mentioned. I idolized them, you get me? These be people where I listen to them and, like, they be my favorite MC. So I just thought it would be fun to create something like that.
Are they still your favorite MC?
Oh, yeah, of course.
So, but have you, I mean, you've done songs with a number of them. Is there one in there that you haven't done a song with yet?
I think Kofi Kinata. I don't know why I don't have a song with him. I keep telling him that, bro, let's do something. I think it's time. Maybe when I did Ghana, he did America. When I did America, he did Ghana. But I'm definitely going to do something with him on the album. I need to get Kofi on.
You know,
that.
I always say that that's one thing we always skip out on in the imagination, that these artists are busy. They move around, you know. So sometimes even getting a chance to be in the studio or getting these collaborations done.
The listener thinks that when you upload the song, though, you gotta sit down.
Yeah, it's crazy.
But it's not the case.
But when did you realize that, bro, I'm booked and busy? What year would you say that this is my breakthrough here? Because
when did the music become work?
I think it was after I dropped Confirm.
Right.
Yeah, confirm. Yeah, my first show was my first paid show was Tidal Rave. I think at that time the Echo House they gave me I think 5K
at a time.
I was so excited because I was like, yo, 50 million. Miko perform me. Wow, that's dope. Yeah, so that was after that it kept, you know, coming on and on and on.
You were home when Shatta drove in with a car to surprise you.
Yeah,
let's talk about that, because you and would you even say that after this whole, you know, jail experience deepened the relationship between you and him?
Yeah, of course, because, you know, over there it's four walls, you are locked, you are in. When they're open, everybody in cell, you just come into the compound. Somebody will go vibe, somebody go there, somebody they bath, somebody they, so you only have your like talking to do. You can't go on social media, you know, if you call. So we talked a lot, we spoke a lot. That's what, you know, we made plans a lot that, you know, when we come out we should be able to do this and that, you know.
I know my brother has been you know, when it comes to award schemes in Ghana, he's fought it hard. And equally you, you've had so many nominations, but and especially even with the rappers. Other rappers seem to always get the final award. Even though we've spoken about awards already, they get the award. But Medikal is getting nominations. Do you feel gutted in any way about the fact that, you know, it's like we're not recognizing Medikal and its achievement that much?
I mean, I have a lot of VGMA awards. I think the recent one, I had like 5 nominations or something. Maybe I might not be talking about awards that much because right now, I just want my music to be impactful. Like, people for listening to me and understand, say, then go feel me come in life. That's where my focus is there right now. You get me? So maybe that'll be where that matter there. But
okay. It gets even deeper.
Yeah.
Wait, I wanted to find out from him, you know, are fans actually, you know, putting or requesting a lot from you now more than before? Because you know how when Medikal got onto the scenes, we saw him give us, you know, back to back. We don't see that a lot now, right? Are you getting, you know, more requests? Are you getting more requests from fans, from people around you to actually put more into your music?
Yeah, you know, one thing people don't know is, as an artist, sometimes you just want to chill. Okay, this be me.
Okay.
You get me? This be me. But I feel like a lot of artists, go through that as well. Sometimes you just want to chill and then, you know, leave a breathing space and then do other things and just keep working in the studio till you get the right thing to put out there. You get me? Maybe if you drop 50 songs, 100 songs, or make the fans that my head gets. But sometimes too, the more you blow, the more the task they get harder. Mm-hmm. You get me? Mm-hmm. So I just feel like, me, my duty is here every year, I forgive at least 3 hit songs. Or you get me? And then release an EP album for my listeners to vibe with. You
that's
get
a
me?
Personal goal.
Yeah, that's my
every
goal.
Every year. Yeah. 3 hit songs.
Every year. Wow. Every year, you find me in there somewhere. You find Stubborn Academy. You find Akanish Odoko Akra. You find I'm $2 for your eyes. You find you get something to jump to. You get me?
So so it's actually deliberate. It's intentional. Like you just said, I'm too jollof for your rice. You know that line will create a conversation. So you put it in there to sustain the hits. Is that what it is? Is it engineered? What I'm trying to say, is everything engineered the way you want it?
I know they say those things like just to, you know, generate some extra buzz or anything. It just be they do them effortless. Now they say what I feel like saying. Like this be,
I know, right?
Like this be, it be line. You get me? Bars. Like, this be me to my own. You get me?
Yeah.
Maybe I'll far up. We'll far up. We can't wait. I don't know. I don't mind. I'm saying, you don't be dope. But in my opinion, that'd be what my listeners, they love.
They love.
You get me? Then they connect to them. Then they vibe with them. So
you get plenty of those lines. Yeah. Like you would always find something in there.
Me, I'm a doctor.
That's my line, though. Like, and they laugh, guy. When I listen to the track, I'm a doctor. Man, I laugh.
Is it easy for you to do these things?
I know. Effortlessly.
Like, does it come effortlessly, like?
Yeah.
Or you're in the shower and a challenge, just get a line like I'm control to.
No. I do the write too. I record as they go. I go record them, pause, record. That's how I record.
Yeah, he just a freestyle. One of his,
I don't write.
It was dope.
So if I think, if let's say I take a shower and I get something, I feel like maybe if I put in a song, it's gonna be dope. It go in my head. So when I record, I go put them for somewhere. In the verse. I go throw it in there somewhere.
The head get hard this. Two terabytes.
Then you know, like maths. Yeah. You be art student.
Yeah, I'll be general student actually.
What was your favorite subject?
Me then I like. Economics. Yeah, I like economics.
Kasem.
Yeah. Money management. Calculation.
Calculation.
Planning and plotting.
You, since we're talking new music, I mean, let's talk about the you and Debbie collaboration. Is it off yours or off hers?
No, it's off mine. It'll be one of the songs I drop with the under the planning and plotting interlude. So I would, like I said, I'll be dropping a couple of tunes before the main album comes out. So it'd be one of the tunes.
Yeah. Visuals on the screen now, you can see that as well. And trust me, when it comes to Debbie, she will definitely slay for you. How did this conversation start? You know, because of course, the last thing that we all forgot, Ghanaian, obviously, Medikal and Debbie know they talk. That's what we all thought, we all think. I mean, I know, of course, they're friends at the back end. But how did this conversation on doing music come to light?
I mean, after, you know, as an artist, when you do record song, if you record and be like, this song, if I put this one for top, it will make sense. You get me? So after recording the song, I was like, yo, I know this might sound some way, but I think Debbie, they fit this song. Like, she's the right person to do a verse on the song. And then I called her, and I was like, hey, what's up? This is Medikal. Can you listen to this song and see if you can...
How was the reception?
She was surprised that, like, yo, I'm calling to ask for a verse. But
prior to that, had you guys been talking?
No.
What do your team think? when you told everybody.
I know, right? We didn't even ask how the wifey take him.
Yeah, they were surprised. Everyone around me was surprised.
Like, but wifey, they tell us already, say be precious and somewhere, so.
So it'd be different person.
Medical and then the studio.
I mean, yeah, everybody was surprised, but I mean, they understand how I operate. I'm a business person. I'm a business-minded person. I like to do things in my way, and it always works out. So they trust me.
How? So we're talking about her reception. You said she was surprised.
Yeah, she was. Of course, she was surprised. But she was like, okay, make sure you hear the song. And I sent a song to her. She was like, it's a very interesting song. She likes it. She's gonna do the verse. And she did the verse and sent it to me.
I'm interested in what the inspiration behind Code and Trophies was. What inspired that song? Because listening to it, I mean, I understand how when the artwork dropped, you people said, oh, it's strictly business and everything. But listening to it, I tried to pinpoint what exactly the inspiration was for that song.
So it'd be about balling, about life being so hard. Life is a bitch sometimes, but I want to win. I still want trophies. Basically, that's it. That's what the song is about, you know, still jamming regardless through whatever life would give you. You know, you still for enjoy life. That's what it is.
When the song was done, obviously you said they were your team was surprised when you said you wanted to do the record with Debbie.
Mm.
But after the song was done, everything was set.
Mm.
How did the team respond?
They were like, hey, why this be different? Like, kind of vibe it is. And I was like, yeah, that'll be the vibe. We'll go with them. Yeah, I like to experiment. And then when I do something, I feel like people no go understand them. But maybe later they will come like them. I just like put them out there. Because me, I do like to explore.
So you see yourself as a disruptor?
Kind of soft.
Mm. was there tension on set?
Not really.
So small?
Because you haven't seen it for like forever.
Yeah. So. Not really. It wasn't. Yeah, it was cool.
Two professionals
working. There were military men, snipers, waiting to shoot him if he made any.
Precious hire, the expendables. Yeah. Yeah. They're around. They don't know. Hello? You do have the line, fella. Yeah, we don't watch him. Don't worry.
Director has been giving strict instructions.
to be fair, Jay, I want to find out from him, though.
Mm.
What does wifey's role on the
Team Medikal?
Team Medikal. What is it like? Is she like COO, CTO? What's her role in Team Medikal?
That one, there be Samuel and Precious. So.
No, and that is for family.
Mm.
But in terms of business, right? Does wifey play a particular role in Team
Medikal?
In
the Medikal brand.
Medikal brand.
I mean, of course, she's my partner. She supports me. I support her as well. That's right.
That's it. So, there's not like maybe like, oh, wifey, maybe you are CEO head of this or
head of security.
Head of
chief security.
Chief security.
National security.
The security part.
Because we've seen it, scenarios like maybe like my own brother, Stone and Louisa.
Louisa, yes.
Mm. Is in his business partner straight.
Yeah, apart from being wifey.
When we know that she's involved in the brand in certain ways. Mm. So,
I mean, I do, you know, businesses. I have a couple of businesses that I run with wifey as well. But when it comes to maybe the medical brand, she doesn't, and her brand too,
you don't
have
any.
Yeah, but they don't give
you job for the fella team top.
Charlie, we still they help each
other. Or you say you don't send CV or they don't request F.
Nah, she get manager, she get, you know, she has a whole team doing
it. But
thing.
what is it like, you know, or would you recommend dating or marrying someone in showbiz? This conversation of, two celebrities dating each other, marrying each other, people often think, oh, it's a no-go area. But you have done it successfully, I want to believe. But people are on the fence when it comes to this conversation. What would you recommend?
I feel like everybody for be able to do what you feel. Don't be scared and trying. If you love somebody, no matter where the person be or where you find the person in road to be, whether it be star or it be lawyer or it be love, we go lead you go there. So you for overlook those things. But if you love the person still and you're not prepared to go that, you know, extra mile and all, maybe you shouldn't take this step. I don't go make anybody feel pressured to go into.
Because the reason I'm asking is because often the conversation is about fighting for the spotlight.
We actually have 3 minutes left.
Yeah, fighting for the spotlight. both of you are in your respective fields. So how are you able to balance, you know, the spotlight conversation? Like, this one is getting too much conversations around here. I'm getting too much conversation about myself and stuff like that. Do you talk about these things or you just separate all these conversations and just march on?
You see, no matter what people are going to talk about you, if you're a celebrity, especially if you're in the spotlight, and here lies the case where I'm a public figure. I'm a public figure. My wife happens to be in the same, you know, position. So we just did. We see a lot of things online and be like, ah, but these people, but it'd be normal to me because, you know, they talk about me, then they talk about me before we even met. You get me? So it's something we already champion in. So we know about them. So it's
not. Lastly, fella, hop. Seth, from here you hop. From here to here, small. 2 million views.
Lastly, I wanted to ask, because you have just a few minutes to go, your Twitter got suspended. The fans want to know, are you going to come back? Because now you speak through Kali J, I think.
Yeah.
One of the
I have a lot of people tweet stuff for me.
But is that it? If you're not going to see Medikal on
Twitter? No, they'll see me. I'll be back on Twitter. They shouldn't worry. I'll be back on Twitter.
Yeah, I'm sure. That's fine. Thank you. You know how he got blocked, right? He got suspended, right?
Yeah.
Somebody reported that.
I didn't know it was you know, it was wrong. Like, maybe somebody they filmed me, like Medikal. Then you put my picture, right?
Yeah.
Maybe at Medikal. Yeah. Then I blocked them. I never knew when they even broke.
But with that issue,
can't you just open a new account and just start off?
I can do that.
Is there a reason why you haven't, or forget them?
I just don't get time for that side yet. Because I didn't communicate with my fans for Snapchat, Instagram, Facebook too. So, you know, sometimes some of the fans, if you can write me for Snapchat, bro, we miss you for Twitter account, Twitter. And I'm like, but we the chat for here. Yes, and me and you, they communicate more.
But when you lost the account, did it hit you? Like, did you, like...
Oh, of course. I was like, but why these people do this to me? Who else, chairman? Swacking come. But I say, Charlie, be normal, Charlie.
Did it affect money?
At all. Not at all.
We hear say you get movie for move. How many minutes make I keep you more? Because I don't know where me and you go sit down chat. You know, so if you call me, say come studio, but I never call me. So as I catch you, how many minutes we can keep you?
Nine five. So I can leave at 9:10. Okay, cool. Like 5 minutes
five
extra.
More minutes. Okay.
So since you have 5 more minutes, let me ask you this.
Wow.
What is the final elevation for you? Not too long ago, we were having a conversation about artists graduating into the level of music executives, you know, so that they could help fix the ecosystem, because we don't have a lot of Ghanaians in these rooms to make decisions on behalf of our music industry to progress it. Are you looking at it in that direction, that one day Medikal could be perhaps in a music executive on Def Jam or maybe on Universal or something, so that he can bring some Ghanaians into that space? Or for you, it's just because you have a real estate and all that, you are good, you don't really...
No, I actually have plans of, you know, bringing I won't call it a system, let's say like a label, you get me, a structure where I go put, you know, upcoming artists on and, you know, talk to the leaders, like people like Jay Foley, and, you know, Jay Foley is a, you know,
he's
senior
big
man, big man.
He's a big man.
You know, he make a lot of things happen for me. But, you know, he too, maybe he fight a lot of things back door way we don't even know about, obviously, because he wishes the industry to be better than it is today. You get me? So, yeah, I have plans. I have such plans. That's what I'm saying, that when I'm 50, I'm not going to be holding a microphone, jumping and, you know, going here and there. But maybe once in a while, if he show up and all. But the goal will be to, you know, make the industry a better place the upcoming ones. Yeah, definitely.
And then when you check the back end of your dashboard, where have you seen, or where is the strangest place you've seen people listening to your music? Like,
I was in Paris, right, with my wife. We had gone to shop. We were from, I think, a Gucci shop or something like that. And then I was waiting. We were waiting for our Uber, and then this white kid with the parents, he was playing Omada on his JBL. It was loud. So I stand there with the kiddie, they watch me. He watched me,
He said to trap be that.
Yeah. And he called his parents and he was pointing at me. And they walked to me. And then their parent was like, my son said he liked your music. And I was like, wow, that's crazy.
White kid listen to a mother.
That's crazy. And some other time, we got to the Italian airport, we were supposed to, they were supposed to let us go. And then they saw Gary in my bag. So when they saw that Gary, I don't know, maybe the mama and auntie said be cool. Okay. So they went to check through the Gary and everything. And they asked me that, what's this? And I said, it's Gary. Okay, they went to check and they came back. They were like, why am I going? I was like, I'm an artist. And they said, what music do I do? And I was like, I do Afrobeat. And I went on YouTube. I played Omada. And the guy started doing that. Omada, a white guy. He was like, I know your song. I know your song.
Wow.
And I was like, whoa, that's crazy, you know? So certain things like that, they make us say, that's why sometimes when I do certain songs and people are like, see this kind of good nonsense. At the same, I'm like, yo, bro, I'm different. Don't expect me to sound like Celine Dion or Al Kelly or Wizkid. This is Medikal, bro. Accept me. Take me as who I am. It is what it is, bro.
What kind of songs do you listen to? Okay. We have just a minute. We'll go one inch quickly. What kind of songs you listen to? Your library, your home? Like, away from your music.
I listen to Jenny Aiko a lot.
Oh, wow.
I love Jenny Aiko. I love Bad Peace. I listen to Afrobeats, too. I listen to Lil Wayne a lot. I listen to Drake. So I listen to, you know, all types of music, like pop, R&B.
I want to hear gospel.
Gospel. Gospel, the American, I mean, tear gospel.
Well, okay.
And yes,
the guy's last prayer gospel. Was last year. Because
I wanted to know what gospel artist or gospel song he was like.
Gospel, they're being shut down tear gospel. So I don't mind, you know, listening to gospel once in a while, but I'm not a big fan, like, every you go find you listening to gospel. Yeah,
that's only the piece you're banned. Our time is up.
I mean, time is up. So, quickly. I wanted to find out how Sister Debbie has impacted your music and your career. Because the blowing of Medikal, when everybody got to know about Medikal, was when you guys paired up as boyfriend and girlfriend. Mm. And then, you know, years down the line, we see this collaboration happen, which, again, has generated some conversation. Mm. So, I just want to know how she has impacted your life, your brand and your career.
Because I was the time now. Okay, no problem. But you see, Deborah also she's an artist, model, actress. Yeah. So there are eyes on her, right? Mm-hmm. And also, I happen to be this, you know, rapper, songwriter, singer in the industry. So obviously, as we come together now, people see I'm like, hey, they know see some before, or they see some chair, like, it be something where you they see I'm online or far abroad. So it just be something where people, they raise them eyebrows, because they be like, whoa, this can actually happen. Are they really doing it, or it's just for clout or hype? Or, but everything be genuine, and she's a nice person. She's a good person. It's not, you know, because if me and the person break up, we go there at loggerheads or something like that. Yeah, so she's positive.
My own DAB request.
Hey, Charlie.
Hip hop is 50 this year. I need you to put out some bars. Despite everything you do, when you're done, I foresee I'm online.
I focus bars right now.
Not right now. I'll give you time.
You better give my fans some bars right now. Right,
deliver jump up, jump up.
I said, hey, I'm who I be. And she said she know the C. And I'm like, it will be clear if she hopped up on the D. She kept turning around the tongue like she wants sign the E. But I never give an F because I told her I'm a G. Ubi Sase me this and me say, I forget my H. She looked deep into my eye. You say, who cry you the G? Me say, on him, I met you, but this is a ultra 30K. Not in more, not in elegant. I'll buy you for pay. Tell your guy I'm not afraid, but I know be Eminem. Meet me a massage with body with baby or your N. I won't tell a word. Why you know they trust baby? Oh, me see Jana uni P. Ubody Nana me pill. You're the only one in line. Others are still in a queue. I'm a classic barbecue. See the other people gossiping. They don't know who we are. Told they be having this space. Someone will be a star. Dreams of owning a church and an escalade. Or get a little tea and get escalated. I explained to you how I live my life and you come devastate. And yet it hurts to blame. I'm flying, mamacita. You don't need a visa. Versace dab like I'm related to Medusa. Who yeah, me the Memphis. Even if they double you, I go lift you up and treat your body like some pizza. Free my war boy from today. Be your ex. Memus I'm a wire that's what you call like Alex. On until you forget to didn't you see me. Or am I you and I made me a Dragon Ball?
Z MDK.
You do have. We actually went through all of the alphabet. Thanks for coming.
We're gonna make up.